We bless the name of the Lord for giving us the grace again to meet on this platform of Sec Ambassadors. We appreciate him for his faithfulness. It's my prayer that he will continue to uphold us all in Jesus' name. Today on this platform of Sec Ambassadors, we want to encourage ourselves on a very important topic. By the grace of God, our topic today is You Can Be Better. You Can Be Better. And we'll be taking the part one of this message. Our text is taken from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17, and we will be studying the life of David. But before we proceed, I would like us to pray. King of Kings, Lord of Lords, we want to appreciate you for the grace you have given us again to meet on this platform of Sec Ambassadors. We appreciate you for your faithfulness. Lord, be glorified in Jesus' name. We thank you because your plan for us is to be better in all areas of our lives. Father, we pray that as we go into this message, you speak to us, and at the end, let your name be glorified. Thank you, King of Glory, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. And so, like I mentioned to us earlier, I'll be speaking to us on the message and topic, You Can Be Better. And this is part one of this topic, and by the grace of God, we'll be having the part two next week, God's willing. One of the important thing, or one of the constant thing in life, for all of us as human in this world is change. Many of us, we actually want to be better than the way we are. By the grace of God, God has helped us to achieve one thing or the other. But then we always want to change. Some people want to change their location. Some want to change their job. Some want to change, you know, how they look. And that means that as far as we are women, as far as we are seen in this world, we always desire a change. And that is why when we were in primary school, and no matter how well we are performed in our examination, our teachers will always make this important comment in our report card. Even if you have come out with the first position, they will still put it there. There is room for improvement. That means that as human, our teachers know that we can always be better. So if our earthly teachers understand this, that means God himself knows that we as his children can actually be better. But then we can also, it's also important for us to understand that this change that we're talking about can either be positive or be negative. And so that means that one can have a positive change and one can also have a negative change. But as far as our God is concerned, as far as the Almighty God is concerned, all that he wants for his children is a positive change. And to understand this concept of change we're talking about in us understanding the topic, You Can Be Better, we want to consider first the two most popular souls in the Bible. In the Bible, we have some souls that are mentioned, but two of them are naturally important. One is mentioned in the Old Testament, at his own time, he was a king. And then the other soul is the one in the New Testament, who eventually became an apostle. And first of all, I'll talk about the first soul in the Old Testament. And the first soul was someone that on his own, he didn't know that God had in mind to make him a king. But eventually, he became the first king in the land of Israel. But then a time came when, when he has been working with the Lord. But then he started to drift. He started, to make some decision without, following the will of God. Eventually, this negative change in his life affected him and caused him to lose his throne. What am I saying in essence? What we are saying in essence is the fact that as children of God, we must be careful of how we conduct ourselves, particularly when it comes to our work with the Lord. We need to be careful not to, begin to retard in our work with the Lord. We need to follow God absolutely, and to obey all his commands. Saul, that became King Saul, lost his throne just because at first he was impatient, in offering, in doing what he was not supposed to do. At the time, he also allowed disobedience. When God instructed him, he did not obey the Lord completely, and that made him to lose his throne. Eventually, it was changed. I pray that in the name of Jesus, God will not replace us in Jesus' name. Another, but that is talking about the first Saul in the Old Testament. Then coming to that, which is a good example of a negative change. I pray that will not be our portion in the name of Jesus. They're talking about a positive change. I would like to remind us of the story of the second Saul, who we can see in the book of Acts. And this Saul was someone that, you know, hated the church. He hated God's people. He, all that he wanted to do was to bring them down. But a time came when he was also going to, you know, to arrest them, to ensure that they actually brought down, that God himself had a divine encounter with him. And that was on his way to Damascus. And God, you know, approached him. And this Saul changed from that time henceforth. And he became a new man. And eventually, this Saul, you know, people around him then, even believers and non-believers, they knew that this Saul has changed. And no wonder his name was changed from Saul to Apostle Paul. Eventually, this Apostle Paul, you know, wrote the most part of the New Testament. So the Apostle Paul himself is a good example of a positive change. So what we are saying today by the grace of God is that as children of God, we can actually be better, no matter what we have been passing through, no matter the areas where we have been struggling. God wants us to be better, and I pray that in the name of Jesus, God will give us that grace to be better in Jesus' name. Amen. Like I mentioned to us earlier, God is interested in our positive change, and that is why, you know, Apostle John, in that story, John chapter 1 verse 2, you know, make us to understand the mind of God better. He says, he make us to understand in that verse that God, you know, wants us to prosper. You know, he wants our soul to prosper. That is his desire for us. But then if you go to the same, to the earlier book of John, that's John chapter 15 verse 5, Jesus Christ make us to understand that there is no way we can do anything or achieve anything significant in this world without him. That means that even if we try to be better spiritually, to be better physically, to be better academically, to be better in any area of our lives, there's no way we can actually do that without, you know, seeking the assistance of the Most High, without, you know, carrying Jesus along. And that is why it is important for us to know that for us to be better, we need the Lord Jesus. Jesus in our lives is what will make the difference. And unlike what is captured in that book of Colossians chapter 1 verse 37, and the part B of that verse says, Christ in us, the hope of glory. That means if you have Christ in you, if you have Jesus Christ in you, definitely you can be sure of a better tomorrow. There is no way we can be better. There's no way we can, you know, progress without allowing, without, you know, the involvement of the Lord Jesus, without Christ, you know, sitting on the throne of our lives. And my encouragement today is that we allow this Jesus, you know, to come into our lives so that we can enjoy, you know, a better tomorrow. And I pray that that will be our testimony in Jesus' name. Then going back to our major main text for today, which is in 1 Samuel chapter 17, we'll see how David, how that young David, how he was able to overcome a very powerful warrior. He overcame Goliath, and Goliath at that time was a giant. You know, he overcame Goliath, you know, not with a spear, not with a gun, not with any AK-47, but just with a stone. And in that book of 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 40, don't make us to understand how David picked up 5 stones, which was what he used in overcoming and Goliath. You know, he only used one of these 5 stones in overcoming Goliath. I want us to understand that for anybody that wants to be great, for anybody that wants to become better, and it is necessary for us to understand this place of these 5 stones for us to be better. It's important for us as God's children, it's important for us as church ambassadors to be able to understand the place of these 5 stones in us becoming better spiritually and also in our circular work. And I pray that the Lord himself will give us understanding in Jesus' name. Having said that, I'd like us to understand that by the grace of God, you know, God make us understand that God in his own, in his mercies, you know, give us, you know, an insight to understand that these 5 smooth stones, which actually brought a permanent solution at that time, because Goliath was continually arousing God's children. These 5 smooth stones represent the grace of God. These 5 smooth stones represent the grace of God. That means what you and I need to be better in all areas of our lives, what you and I need to be better in that area of our lives where we are struggling, what you and I need in our families, what you and I need in our career, is the grace of God. And I pray that God himself will make that grace available to us on a continual basis in Jesus' name. You know, before, you know, everybody, when David conquered Goliath, everybody at that time they were so happy, you know, they celebrated him, but not knowing the fact that David himself, you know, in the earlier chapter that I was talking about, 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 13, has been anointed, you know, God in that verse, that's 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 13, you know, we are made to understand that Prophet Samuel went and anointed David. And that makes us understand that from that day henceforth, the Spirit of the Lord, you know, came upon him powerfully. That means that David from that time became a new person. David at that time, you know, became somebody, you know, very, very different. He was anointed, and it wasn't just an ordinary anointing. That will make us understand that he was anointed powerfully. And I pray that in the name of Jesus, that you and I will also enjoy that powerful anointing of God that will make us different, that will make us better in the name of the Lord Jesus. And so this anointing of God, the grace of God in the life of David, you know, helped him to be able to conquer Goliath. It wasn't that stone that he used was that strong enough to bring Goliath down. No, something that David could calculate, you know, how, where the stone should hit. Something that David, you know, knew how to just throw the stone very well. No, it wasn't that David was that smart. It was just because the grace of God in his life, the anointing of God that was so powerful in life, spoke for him. And that anointing of God was there, you know, to bring down Goliath, which was a needed passport, a needed ticket, or needed visa for him to become the king of Israel. And it's my prayer that today is that in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, every Goliath standing on our way to our throne, the Lord himself will bring them down in Jesus' mighty name. And as we close this evening, I want us to understand that there's no way anybody can truly become prosperous. There's no way anyone can truly become successful without the touch of God. And you may want to argue that with me. You know, you may want to say that there are some unbelievers that are thriving without them, you know, without Christ in their lives. But I want you to tell you, Bible makes us understand that what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? That means if somebody is let's say rich in this world and eventually is not rich towards God, so what kind of riches are we going to call that? What kind of wealth are we going to call that? So that means the true wealth, the true prosperity, the true success only comes when we have Jesus Christ in our lives. And the book of Joshua chapter 1 verse 8 make us understand that, you know, for us to have good success, we need to meditate on the word of God. We need to have a very good relationship with God. And I pray God will give us that grace to relate with him better, in us becoming better individuals in Jesus' name. As we close this evening, I want us to remember this, that for us to become better, you and I need Jesus in our boat. For us to become better in our spiritual life, to become better academically, to become better in our finances, to become better in every areas of life, we need Jesus in our boat. And if you are there and you are yet to, you know, accept Jesus Christ into your life, I want to encourage you that it's not too late. If you are there struggling and you think maybe you can do it by own strength, I'm here to let you know that Bible makes us understand that by strength shall no man prevail. So you cannot do that yourself. You cannot fight that battle yourself. And that is why you need Jesus in your life to help you. And that Jesus is there, is knocking at the door of your heart for you to accept him. And I assure you that as we accept him today, Jesus will turn your life around and you'll become a better individual in the name of Jesus. And by the grace of God, we'll be continuing and this message, having the part two of this message next week, God's willing. And I pray that the name of Jesus, if the Lord tarries in his coming, we'll be able to have that time together in his message in Jesus' name. As we close today by the grace of God, we'll be closing with this last verse in the Bible. And with the prayer, our prayer will be from the last verse in the scriptures, and that's in book of Revelation chapter 22. Verse 21, Revelation 22 verse 21, which also captures the place of the grace of God in us becoming better. And our prayer today is, Father, please let the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ continue to be with me. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Father, we pray that in the name of Jesus, that Lord, as we go in this week, as we go in the rest of the year, as we go in the rest of our lives, let your grace go with us. Father, as we begin, you know, to live a life of becoming better, as we desire to become better in all walks of life, we pray in the name of Jesus, let your grace speak for us. Thank you, King of Glory, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. I want to appreciate the name of the Lord for giving us the opportunity to meet again on the plan of Second Ambassadors. We want to believe that you have been blessed, and it's my prayer that as we have desire to become better, God Himself will make us better in every area of our lives in Jesus' name. You can still reach us on and our different social media platforms, and it's my prayer that God Himself will strengthen us. Also, till we meet again next week, Sunday, by the grace of God, please have a wonderful week and a prosperous week ahead. Thank you, and God bless you. Thank you. Bye.